All right, it's mission accomplished. Congratulations to you. Meantime, Ms. David, you know, you mentioned earlier about the experience. This gave you, of course, insights on the kind of threats that our fishermen and even our defense forces are continuously facing as they venture into the West Philippine Sea. Perhaps can you give us an idea of what these threats are and how you felt about this when you experienced the threats yourself?
Well, first and foremost, our advance team was encircled by a Chinese Navy ship, all while they were trying to distribute food packs. But again, it was an exhibition of the bravery of the Filipinos, because even with the Chinese Navy ship going around them, they continued forward giving supplies. And there was even a Chinese helicopter trying to intimidate them. For our main convoy, another instance of Filipino bravery is when the Chinese Coast Guard was going around us. It was not just shadowing, it was really encircling and going very near, even as half a mile away from us. But again, our fisherfolk communities continued forward in conducting fishing activities. So even despite what they were doing, we saw our volunteers moving forward. Of course, this is an act of intimidation from China, but also at the same time, this endangers also the regular activities that they're doing, because you can really see the effort to to get the, not just to intimidate, but the small fishing vessels, of course, are really also put at risk, and their safety are also compromise.
All right. Now, Ms. David, you mentioned about, you know, intimidation in the West Philippine Sea. I don't know if this development, the latest development, where China's now ordering or contemplating on arresting and even detaining those that are in their so-called territory. I don't know if that was a result of your recent trip to the West Philippine Sea, but what are your thoughts on this, on the way China is dealing with the situation, with the pronouncements that it will arrest even possibly even Filipinos that are you know, that are venturing into the area or the territory that they claim is theirs?
Yeah, we see this as a direct response to our civilian supply mission, and it definitely looks like a desperate attempt for China to keep a hold of their illegal occupation of the West Philippine Sea. This for us is also an indication that active citizenship as a model is an effective model in challenging China, because it seems like China is the one who's actually afraid when people come together and show the this big superpower that they will not be silenced, they will come together and speak truth to power.
Now, Ms. David, you described the latest civilian supply missions in the West Philippine Sea as short of heroic. In fact, you are saying that, you know, this as a strategy is effective in the Philippines asserting our rights in our own territory. Now, the question is, would there be succeeding or immediate supply missions that you're planning in the area in the coming days?
Well, we've always been saying that we should be regularizing and normalizing civilian access in the West Philippine Sea. This should not actually be controversial. Ordinary citizens should have regular access to our own seas. If China is militarizing our area, our mission is to civilianize it, making sure that we bring it back to normal. We make sure that we bring it back to ordinary Filipinos, especially the fisherfolk who are most affected and who are the traditional occupants of that area.
And lastly, Ms. David, what do you say to those who think going there is not a good idea and that we should not even venture? I mean, at least civilians. It is too risky for civilians to be going to an area that is highly contested or hotly contested.
Well, that's going to be playing into the Chinese narrative that, again, Filipinos should stay out of our own waters. So if anyone's making that area risky, it's China, again, who's militarizing it. And for us, you know, it's going out there, facing also the risks, also shows how a peace-loving nation, through peaceful means, can be determined, undeterred by what China is doing, show that we will not be silent again, because it's a moral obligation in the face of a bully that we come together and show China that we will not be silenced.
All right, on that note, Rafaela David, co-convener of Atin Ito Coalition, thank you so much for joining us today. And thank you so much for believing in the mission.
Thank you, Stanley.